Welcome back to Bella. If you've just tuned in, we're talking about how to accessorize your Baju Raya. Now, let's talk about the krongsang. How can we use it? They come in obviously different sizes. Maybe we can talk a little bit about sizes and also how to use it.
All right, the krongsang normally comes in a set of three.
Okay.
Because the first one will be like the top one with the bigger size,
yes.
And the bottom two with the smaller ones. Or the next one, they have all the three same sizes, mm-hmm. but they're connected with a chain.
Okay.
And also, you can also have different, brooches. I mean, same sizes, but you wear it
separated.
That's right.
Is there a reason why there are three? A little bit of history to this?
I'm not too sure.
Because there's two, right?
But in the older days, because they don't have any buttons.
The buttons, right?
That's why they need those to fasten it. Then probably that's why the chain will come in handy, so that you'll not actually open up.
So are there any other ways we can use it? The obvious way is you pin it here, right? On your normally when you wear kabaya, right?
Kabaya, of course. That's right.
Any other styles of how to use it? Has anyone sort of, modernized it a little
for
bit?
For me, I'm as a young people. Mm-hmm. If I'm going out, for example, movie and everything, mm-hmm. I will wear it with my skirts. I will pin it with my plain t-shirts.
Where do you pin it?
On my belt.
Oh, you pin it on the belt.
Yeah.
Okay.
To make
so
it
what? One, two.
No, only
just one. Okay. I was like, one, two,
three. Yeah, but it depends. It depends. After all, it's all about the balancing.
Yeah. Okay. Well, as a fashion designer, what do you think is the most crucial part when it comes to giving advice to your customers, to women in general, mm-hmm. about maintaining the balance between accessories and your outfit? Because you see so many women out there who they wear such colorful outfits and then they put all this bling on them and they look like a Christmas tree, you know? And then you have the ladies out there who are so scared to accessorize. They, mm-hmm. you know, to them, a small necklace, oh, it's too big, it's too much, you know? So how do you encourage your
Okay, normally you advise them first. You look at the fabric, the design, and if the baju is already complicated, like with the beading, embroideries, so we have to minimize the using all the accessories.
Okay.
And then it's also depends to what occasion you want to go.
Yeah.
Not too much and not too heavy, mm-hmm. because it will spoil the beauty of the baju.
Okay, so the general rule would be less is more. So if your baju is a little bit busier, more colors, more florals, more beadwork, mm-hmm. then keep the accessories simpler.
Very simple,
or else if your outfit is a lot simpler, then you can go all out.
Maximize it. Yes.
You can maximize
something that can fit your size.
Let's talk about some of these pieces out here that we have on the table today. We talked about the brooches earlier, how we could wear them. Mm-hmm. Bangles are always fun.
Yeah.
And these are actually really pretty, although they're a bit too small for me. At least.
They are bought from India.
Very pretty. And I'm sure, you know, to incorporate these into your daily style, it's very...
It can be.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, what about, we have a lot of traditional accessories here. How can we, any advice we can give women as to how to wear these with sort of everyday modern clothes? We talked about the krongsang earlier, how you pin it on your belt and the brooches, necklaces, you know, even those buckles, that you tie with sarongs with. How can we include those in our everyday wear?
I mean, for the necklace, right, you can just wear a plain shirt with a necklace, it looks great. Mm-hmm. To offices, even to outings, for outings as well.
Okay.
Yeah. And
for special occasion, mm-hmm. maybe you want to attract the audience to look loud. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can wear something bigger, something different from mm-hmm. your daily wear. Then maybe you can try with the doko and the krongsang.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
And from the designer's perspective, okay. How do you
for me,
operate?
It depends how she can carry all these things.
Yeah.
Some of women, even though you just put a simple one, you can't see Well, the detail of that.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's why it depends on someone itself.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But also a lot of women that have, you know, that we've met on the show and that feel that they don't have the confidence to carry a lot of pieces, yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, and how can they overcome this? How would you, what advice would you give them to overcome this? Because to them, they look at this and they get scared, mm. quite literally. Hello, no.
I think they should be brave enough to try. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because and to develop their own style as well. You know, I mean, it might not suit somebody else, but you know, as long as you feel comfortable and you're happy with it,
go on. And there's no harm trying.
Yes, yeah. No harm trying.
Okay, so talking about colors, you know, you've got gold, you've got silver. Bronze, you've got silver, mm-hmm. you've got rose gold nowadays. Rose gold is very popular. Yeah. Mm-hmm. How do we wear these colors? What colors suit people better? Are there any?
No, it depends on the budget itself. Also.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sometimes gold is only can go with some colors. Some. Mm-hmm. And silver also, we have to see the colors and the budget. Mm-hmm. And the occasion too.
Yeah, the occasion.
Yeah, I think, I mean, your skin color plays an important part as well.
Yes.
Because like gold, I mean, if your skin tone is a bit darker, so gold looks very nice.
Yes. Right.
Yeah, if you're fairer, then you go for the rhodium and silver.
Okay.
Yeah. Correct me if I'm wrong. For me, I think there's no do and don'ts in accessories. Because as long as it suits with you, as long as you're comfortable with it, then just proceed it.
Yeah, and you're right. I think especially today, people wear whatever they want, mm-hmm. whenever they want, and they mm-hmm. mix it and match it.
It can be silver with pink mm-hmm. or any funky colors.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, and so for Raya this year, you know, obviously a lot of open houses, a lot of entertaining, mm-hmm. and if you're not hosting your own house, mm-hmm. you're visiting about 5 houses a day.
Yeah.
So moving around a lot, what you know, as a designer, what do you recommend women wear to be comfortable, of course, right, and obviously to stay cool as well.
Yeah, like we discussed just now, it depends on the budget. If the budget is very complicated and with the heavy beads or embroidery, we make it less. The accessory is less, mm-hmm. and if the budget is simple, mm-hmm. so we maximize it. Yeah,
yes.
On the accessories.
Mm. Yeah, I think. But then to be comfortable, I think to go to one open house to another, you should have something loose and no flowy, and you could just wear it with a necklace,
yes.
and it looks great.
Yeah, open house is something. Fun things,
yes.
Yeah,
and eating a lot,
yeah,
not something too tired.
Yeah. Maybe you should wear something that makes you look happy. Maybe something that makes you look wow on that day, because you will see, you meet a lot of your friends, your relatives. Maybe you can try to not attract everyone, but wear something different.
Yeah. Yeah.
After all, Raya is once a year.
Why not, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good stuff. Well, we're going to take another quick break, and when we come back, this is what we have for you. We're going to talk about how to care for your precious pieces and also how to recycle some old accessories that you have lying around at home. See you after this.